Today on Bronco News Now, we have the latest on the music department controversy, and a look at some students who have been hard at work in the art department.
And looking ahead to your weather, we've had storms and rain showers over the last couple of days. Tune in to find out if there's more to come later in the show.
And coming up in sports, see how the track team did in their outdoor conference meet, plus how the men's tennis team is gearing up for nationals. Stay tuned. This is Bronco News Now.
Live from Hastings College Gray Center, Studio A, this is Bronco News Now. With news anchor Nick Musgrave, Joey Kemwin, entertainment with Jordan Brown, weather with Laurel Teal, and sports with Russell Hyman. You're watching Bronco News Now.
Good afternoon and welcome to Bronco News Now. I'm Nick Musgrave. A child has been abducted from Omaha near southeast Nebraska. The Omaha Police Department is looking for a child who was last seen at 2324 South 10th Street, Omaha, Nebraska, and is believed to be in danger. The child's name is Jose Ramirez Marinero. He is a 5-year-old male with short black hair and was last seen wearing a gray shirt and gray sweatpants. The child may be in the company of an unknown suspect. They may be traveling in a 2000 silver Jeep Cherokee with Nebraska plate SRH941 that was last seen heading in an unknown direction. If you have any information on the whereabouts of Jose Ramirez Marinero, please call 911 and contact the Omaha Police Department at 402-444-5656 immediately.
Thank you, Nick. A controversy has hit social media accounts this week about the music department. At Hastings College, Mackenzie Weddell has the latest updates.
Posts were made early this week on Facebook indicating that the music department would be reducing its number of faculty from 12 to 6. However, this is not the case, according to Vice President for Academic Affairs, Gary Johnson.
We do have a situation in music where we've had some lower enrollments in terms of music majors over the last, probably 10 years or so. And as you're well aware, the college itself is in a situation where we're trying to, you know, make sure we're fiscally responsible, so we're watching our budgets and watching our staffing.
The one thing that is for certain is that vocal performance professor Chip Smith is retiring, and his position will not be filled next year.
There's one retirement in music this year, and we have decided that we're not going to hire a full-time replacement for next year.
For HC Media, I'm Mackenzie Weedle.
Johnson will be working with musical department chair director Robin Kuser on developing a strategic plan for the future.
Another issue revolving around the music department is the number of students enrolled in the marching bands, symphonic bands, in the marching band and symphonic bands has recently dropped. Austin Rem has the story.
For nearly 90 years, Hastings College has had a symphonic band, followed shortly by the marching band, which remains today as one of the only marching bands in the GPAC conference. Dr. Daniel Lang, the director of the bands, has been here for nearly 8 years and feels Hastings College offers a unique program within the music department.
But I think what really makes us unique is that the students here at Hastings College are involved in everything. So, for example, if you go to Doane College, you have the choice to be in the marching band or be in a concert band. Or if you go to Kearney, you can, you know, do one or the other. Or at UNL, for example, you have your choice of multiple ensembles to be a part of. Here at Hastings College, the students are involved in all of our band ensembles together. So everybody plays in symphonic band, everybody plays in marching band. And because of that, it makes us, I think, a closer unit. And I think you make better friendships. And you feel part of the bigger picture versus at other institutions, you're part of more of a I don't want to say a clique, but a smaller ensemble that you don't necessarily get to meet the other kids in those other ensembles. But here, everybody's one cohesive unit, and I think that's what makes us unique here at Hastings College.
This past school year, the band has seen a drop in enrollment, hitting a low of 82 students, the lowest it has been since Dr. Lang has been at Hastings College. Dr. Lane credits this recent drop in enrollment in the band to the busyness of students' schedule and the misconception of exactly how much time being involved with the band would consume.
It's a tough thing because students think the band is a big commitment. They're afraid that if they commit to it, it's going to be, you know, time suck and they're not going to be able to do anything else. And that's really untrue. It's less of a time commitment than any of our sports. It only meets 50 minutes a day. And so just doing a better job of promoting those things, I think, will help boost the numbers a little bit.
Dr. Lang feels that the cohesiveness and family-orientated focus within the band helps when recruiting prospective students.
When recruiting students, I just tell them it's a big family. And if you want to be part of a nice, close-knit group of people who want to be there and are committed to making excellent music, I think it's a great organization to be a part of.
Although the numbers in the band have seen a drop, Dr. Lang feels confident that with the help of current students, along with the department and the college, the band could easily double in size. The Hastings College Band remains as one of the largest student organizations on campus and provides the college and the surrounding community with exciting entertainment. For HC Media, I'm Austin Rem.
Be sure to keep up with the scheduled football games, parades, concerts, and more to see the Bronco Band. Now let's get a quick look at what our weather is going to look like from Laurel Teal.
Good afternoon, I'm Laurel Teal with your weather update. Last night, a tornado struck Roslyn, Nebraska, a town 15 miles west of Hastings. Fortunately, there were no injuries reported, but houses did receive damage. Our thoughts and prayers go out to those affected by the tornado. For today's weather, Hastings will see a high of 75 degrees, with clouds varying throughout the day. Winds are coming from the north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. And if you're looking to go outside before the weekend, today would be a great day to do so. Moving into this evening, we'll be seeing a low of 50 degrees, and we can expect the skies to clear up around 8 p.m. tonight. There's a slight chance of precipitation, but we shouldn't see any heavy rainfall, and winds will be continuing to come from the north at 10 to 15 miles per hour. That's a quick look at your weather for today. I'll have your entire forecast later in the show. Now, back to Nick and Joey at the desk.
Earlier this week, a number of Hastings College students participated in the campus's It's On Us campaign. It's On Us is a national campaign to raise awareness about sexual assault. The students put together multiple social media pages dedicated to the campaign at HC and set up a booth in HSU where anyone on campus could take a pledge to help prevent sexual assault. The campaign only lasted a week here at Hastings, but those involved would like to encourage everyone to actively instill concepts of the It's On Us campaign year-round.
When we return, Laurel Teal has your extended five-day forecast.
And later in the show, we'll take a look at how common leg injury have affected a number of HC students. But first, we'd like to thank our sponsor, Subway. Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 68. I'm Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
Now, your Bronco weather with Laurel Teal.
Welcome back. I'm Laurel Teal with your weather forecast. We've seen some stormy weather over the past few days, but let's take a look at what we're expecting for today. In case you missed it earlier, today Hastings will be seeing a high of 75 degrees, with clouds varying throughout the day. Winds are coming from the north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour, and again, be sure to head outside today and enjoy the nice weather while you have the chance. Moving into this evening, we'll be seeing a low of 50 degrees, and once more, we can expect the skies to clear up around 8 p.m. tonight. There's a small chance of precipitation, but it shouldn't see any heavy rainfall, and winds will continue to come from the north at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Now let's take a look at rising temperatures across the state. Out west, we have Chadron resting at about 57, Scotts Bluff a little warmer at 62, along with Sydney, and Valentine in the north at 61. North Platte will be at 67 degrees and McCook at 73. Switching over to this side of the state now, Norfolk will be at 75 degrees, with Hastings also at 75, and Lincoln, our capital, at 78. Now the state lows. Tonight, Chadron will be seeing about 34 degrees, Scotts Bluff 41, and Sydney 38. Valentine will be about 40 degrees, with North Platte at 42, McCook at 47, and Norfolk at 49. Hastings and the college here will be seeing around 50 degrees, and Lincoln 54. Now, let's take a look at the next 5 days to see how the weather is going to look over the weekend and into the beginning of finals week. Friday, we'll see a 60% chance of showers and thunderstorms with a high of 69 degrees. Winds will be from the north at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Friday night, we'll have an increased chance of storms with a low of 50 degrees and winds continuing from the north at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night will be a high of 68 degrees with a 40% chance of thunderstorms. Winds will switch from the east at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Saturday night, there will be a low of 55, with thunderstorms likely, including some that may be severe. Winds will continue from the east at 15 to 25 miles per hour. For Sunday, we'll see some rain chances dwindle down to 20% with partly cloudy skies. Winds will be a gusty 20 to 30 miles per hour as we reach the high of 68 degrees. And Sunday evening, winds will switch to the west at 15 to 25 miles per hour as we'll see mostly cloudy skies and a low of 39. Looking into the start of next week, we'll see temperatures drop off a bit, reaching a high of just 60 degrees with northwest winds between 20 and 30 miles per hour and mostly cloudy skies. And Monday evening, we'll drop down to 39 degrees for the start of finals week, but winds will stay fairly strong at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tuesday will warm back up to a high of 68 degrees, and the sun should be shining for most of the day. And Tuesday night, we'll see the wind change around to the southeast, bringing a slight chance of rain with a low of 46 degrees. That's your weather forecast for the next 5 days. Looks like a pleasant forecast for the most part, but beware of some of the thunderstorm chances, especially as we move into early next week. After a short break, we'll have more news and entertainment. Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
Bronco News with Nick Musgrave and Joey Kendall. And Entertainment with Jordan Brown.
Welcome back to Bronco News Now. Every athlete fears going down with an injury. Many times one step can be the difference between a full season or missing it completely. Austin Juice took a closer look into ligament injuries in the news with a few Hastings College athletes and a local physical therapist.
Usually, it's more common in females. There's a lot of different factors that play into like ligament injuries. If you want to talk the ACL, 70 to 80% of all ACL injuries are non-contact, meaning there's probably an underlying muscle imbalance. Sometimes they contribute to females having a different Q angle, maybe an angle in their knee that's not advantageous for not tearing their ACL.
Playing basketball, it like 3 minutes into a game, and I attacked and just took a step and it gave out on me. I instantly knew it was my ACL just because I heard it pop 3 times and all of my older sisters have torn their ACL, so it kind of runs in the family and it was bound to happen to me.
So, it was our spring football game last year on March 29th, I think, and I was rolling out to the right side of the field, and then there was a defender coming head on, and so I went to go plant off my left knee or left foot and cut out. And then it just buckled, and I dropped straight to the turf. I instantly knew something was wrong. I was hoping I didn't tear my ACL and meniscus, but unfortunately, that's what happened.
The weekend warriors are the ones that we see, the 35-year-old guys who've torn their ACL playing basketball or tear the meniscus. That's pretty common. A lot of times, preventatively, if you can be in shape before you go out and play just on the weekend, make sure that your knee is in both knees, that basically you're running, you're doing some type of running activity, even straight line running, and doing some type of strengthening activity, you have a lot less chance of that happening. If you go out and you just play cold and you're overweight and you're not as in shape as you should be, you're having more likelihood to have that happen.
For more information on knee injuries or Austin's interview with Corey and Maria, head over to hcmediaonline.org.
11 HC Art students participated in their junior thesis art exhibit last Friday. Reporter Dan Miller has more.
Last Friday, junior-level art students got the opportunity to display work they have created throughout the past semester at the annual Junior Thesis Art Exhibit. The exhibit allowed students to get a first-hand experience of creating their own art show. The basis of this exhibit is to prepare students for their senior thesis projects in the upcoming year. The artwork presented consisted of paintings, ceramics, printmaking, glassblowing, graphic art, and sculpture. Art professor Turner McGee said that the variety of different mediums of art exhibited made this year's show unique.
Every year is unique. Really, you know, there's no pattern because people get interested in such different things. Every year people surprise me with unique inventions. Mm-hmm. And this year is no different from any other.
The students have a lot of freedom with their projects and the medium they choose to focus on. Influences play a major role on sculpting each artist's path to creating the work they presented at the exhibit. Native American art student Grant Parks was influenced by another Native American artist, Preston Singletary, to create various hand-blown glass piece horns, which he then sandblasted to create a design.
It's very, very rewarding. Definitely learned a lot, not only about myself, but just this series has taught me, and I've kind of grown with this series over the past semester.
One of the challenges for many students building a general thesis project is the difficulty to get the desired results on the first attempt.
Well, I know for a fact glass is really hard. I've had a couple of pieces break when I thought they were finished. Like I was working in my airplane and I was trying to get through it so I could hang it, and then it fell and broke. So, and that was a month before the show, and I was like freaking out.
The junior thesis exhibit took place in downtown Hastings on 2nd Street. Professor Steve Snell said that he hopes the art show had a positive effect on the community of Hastings.
I hope it has a positive effect, especially doing it in the downtown area and in an empty storefront. I see that as like an asset to the community, especially since we lost the one and only gallery in town, you know.
Reporting for HC Media, I'm Dan Miller.
Thanks, Dan, and congratulations to those students for completing their junior thesis art projects. We know it's a very time-consuming project.
Now let's send it over to Jordan Brown with your entertainment news. Jordan?
Thanks, guys, and good afternoon, Bronco Nation. I have just what you guys need to make your weekend a little more exciting, so let's get to it. If you're looking for a fun activity this Saturday, I have just a thing. The 5th Annual Bronco Bash. This pre-final tradition is a way for AC students to have some fun before exams. This year will feature a barbecue, a sand volleyball tournament, a car smash, bubble soccer, and paint wars. Sounds like a great way to relieve some stress. Speaking of stress, finals week is upon us, which means stress levels will be high. To help with that stress, I have a few activities that will keep your mind right. Try watching Netflix in between study sessions, watch a throwback like the newly added National Treasure, or a new well-reviewed series like Daredevil. You can even take a look at the most popular One Tree Hill. If that isn't a thing or you don't have a Netflix subscription, try relaxing in hammocks across campus that recently returned. If you feel like breaking a sweat, then grab a group of people and get a game of sand volleyball going. Ball out on final, guys. If you find some time to take a break from studying and feel like heading to the silver screen, this week has a few movies that you might want to check out. My first suggestion is Hot Pursuit. It stars Reese Witherspoon and Sofia Vergara. Reese Witherspoon plays an uptight cop who tries to protect the widow of a drug boss, played by Vergara. They race through Texas while being pursued by crooked cops and dangerous gunmen. Definitely a great movie for a group of girlfriends to see. My second movie is The D-Train. This stars Jack Black and James Marsden. The head of a high school reunion committee travels to Los Angeles to track down the most popular guy from this graduating class and convince him to go to the reunion. Sounds like an interesting comedy. But that's all I got, guys, for this week. But after the break, Austin Juice has the latest on all things spring sports as the season comes to a close. But first, I'd like to thank our proud sponsor, Subway. Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
Now, your Broncos sports with Austin Bruce.
Good afternoon, Bronco Nation. I'm Austin Drews, filling in for Russell Heitman today with all things Bronco sports. We have a lot of great things for you today, so let's get started. The Hastings College men's tennis team is heading back to the NAIA National Championship. This comes after the Broncos swept through GPAC regular season play for the fourth straight year to capture the regular season championship. The team defeated Midland 5-0 and Doan 5-1 in the GPAC tournament to claim the conference postseason crown as well. The team next looks forward to a trip to Mobile, Alabama, where they will open play in the NAIA Championship against William Carey University of Mississippi on Tuesday. Head coach Kamran Yazgirdi is confident in his team, but knows it won't be an easy road to victory.
I know going into it, there are three guys that are just, or three positions that are just super good. But I feel like, you know, we have a chance to win 5 out of 6, 7 matches. I wish tennis was a Cinderella story, but instead of winning one basketball game, you got to win 5 individual games to pull off an upset.
The Broncos received the lowest seed in the bracket, and should they advance to the second round, they would play San Diego Christian on Wednesday. Best of luck to the tennis team. The Hastings College baseball team secured its first winning season in 4 years as they finished with a 24-23 overall record in the second season under Coach Sponberg. The Broncos entered the GPAC tournament as the 6th seed and lost their opening game 6-0 to Morningside. However, the Broncos bounced back on day 2, eliminating rival and 2-seed Doan College from the tournament by a final score of 5-4. The Broncos followed that up by avenging their loss to Morningside by winning 3-0. The Broncos season came to an end eventually against the eventual GPAC championship Dakota Wesleyan in a 12-4 decision. Head coach Steve Sponberg thought his team started to click at the right time.
We felt like toward the end of the year we made progress. We probably played our best baseball. We played more emotionally into the game, which we have to do to be successful. And I think our kids believe that now they can win. So we certainly hope that carries over into next year. And with the addition of some pieces here or there, we can be a team that has an opportunity to be reckoned with within the conference.
Hastings College pitcher Will Reynolds received GPAC Conference second team honors this season, while 5 other Broncos were honorable mention selections. The Bronco track teams competed at the conference meet this past weekend to see where they lined up in the GPAC. Austin Penfield was there and has the story.
The Hastings College men's and women's track teams traveled to Sioux Center, Iowa last weekend to compete in the 2015 Outdoor Track and Field GPAC Championship meet at Dort College on May 1st and 2nd. Both squads performed well, as the women placed 5th out of 11 teams and the men placed 7th out of 10 teams. Between the two squads, 7 athletes were crowned GPAC champions in their respective events, including Lauren Shoemaker in the women's 5,000 and 10,000 meter runs, Jennifer Mag in the women's shot put, Cody Jackson in the men's pole vault, and Antonio Duncan, Sean Robnette, Ricardo Bailey, and Matthew Giudice in the men's 4x400 meter relay. The men's 4x800 meter relay, consisting of Will Baird, Ricardo Bailey, Tyler Penfield, and Matthew Giudice, broke the school 4x800 meter record with their time of 7 minutes and 53 seconds. Ryan Mahoney, head coach for the men's and women's track and field teams, is proud of his athletes' individual performances, despite the team's overall ranking not being where he wanted them to be.
You know, I thought we had a lot of really good individual performances. Some of our athletes that were borderline national qualifiers got in, you know, some highlights. Cody Jackson winning pole vault was big. I thought Michelle Tucan had a big performance in pole vault. Jen winning the shot put, throwing well in disc and hammer was good. Lauren dominating performances in the 10K and 5K. Men's 4x1, hit an A standard, ran really well. I thought that the men's 4x4 winning another dominating performance. So individually good, you know. The team finishes place-wise aren't where I want them to be, and it's just, we just need more depth. We need more athletes. We need a bigger team to compete with the larger teams in the conference right now.
So far, Hastings has qualified 14 athletes for the 2015 NAI Men's and Women's Outdoor Track and Field National Championship Meet. Mahoney hopes his teams will perform well when they travel to Nationals later this month.
Just improvements, more performances that, are better than what we've done so far. I hope that our best is yet to come.
The national meet is to be held at Gulf Shores, Alabama on May 21st through the 23rd. For HC Media, this is Austin Penfield.
Athletes who are on the verge of qualifying for the national meet have one more shot of doing so this Friday in Seward, Nebraska at the Concordia Twilight Meet. We'd like to wish you congratulations and best of luck. With spring sports finally entering postseason play, all 19 regular season champions that are tallied into the GPAC All-Sports Trophy have been named, and the results are in. Following the winter season, Hastings College was sitting in second place behind Concordia, and unfortunately, both Doan College and Northwestern made moves during the spring season, causing Hastings College to tie with the Red Raiders of Northwestern for third place in the standings behind runner-up Doan College and the champion, the Concordia University Bulldogs. We'd like to thank and congratulate all of our sport teams on their campus for their hard work this season and throughout the year. Best of luck in the offseason and next year. Unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for your Broncos sports this week and this semester. We'll be back after a quick break. But before that, we'd like to thank Russell Heitman for all of his work this semester. We would like to send our best wishes. He's battling some stuff, and he is looking to get back and ready for finals. Stay tuned. You're watching Bronco News Now.
NFC, AFC, offensive linemen, defensive tackles, quarterbacks, and cornerbacks are all living united to ensure the academic success of millions of kids in our communities all the way to graduation day. But that won't happen without you. So take the pledge at unitedway.org. Make a difference in the life of a child. Suit up like your favorite NFL players and become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor with United Way.
You wouldn't let money just blow out of your house. So when your AC or heater is on, make sure the doors, windows, and fireplace flue are shut tight. If you're headed out, turn down the AC or lower the heat by 10 degrees. And always keep your water heater set at 120. A little bit of common sense goes a long way. Get more great tips at energysaver.gov.
Good afternoon and welcome to Bronco News Now. Unfortunately, that's the last show of the year.
Thanks for tuning in every week for the latest news, weather, and sports. Remember, you can always check out acmediaonline.org for continuous campus coverage.
I think we could all agree here at BNN, we take news, not ourselves, very seriously. With that being said, let's take a look at some of our favorite mishaps throughout the past year.
Good afternoon and welcome to Bronco News Now. I'm Nick Musgrave. Our top story today, Hastings College was visited by a group of academic evaluators going to look like today from Austin Drews.
Thanks, Nick. Taking a quick look at our weather forecast for today, this afternoon we'll reach a high of 65 degrees.
That is your weather forecast for the next few days. Be sure to tune in for BNN next week for some more updates as well.
High dress is optional but encouraged. Arr.
All right, well, thanks for that.
Coming up, Austin Juice will update you on all your Bronco sports. But before we check in with weather anchor Abby Smith to find out whether or not we will have more snow this weekend. Like past performances, the box office will not be open before the production, so students must get their tickets ahead of time. Theater isn't only our group happening this semester.
Zero. I can't wait to see what campus will look like with more snow. Now let's take a look at your next five. Today.
Welcome back to Bronco News Now. I'm Austin Drews with your sports. We have a lineup as big as my hair today, so let's get rolling. The Hastings College men's soccer team kept their GPAC tournament hope.
Let's now talk with entertainment reporter Jordan Brown. Jordan, what exciting things is happening this weekend?
Thanks, Joey and Nick. If you're a student you love Hastings College, present the students. Do you enjoy helping recruit events on campus? Yes, yes.
Are you interested in sharing your love for Hastings? All right, well, thank you all, and I sure hope everyone who has turned in these last two semesters has enjoyed watching BNN as much as we have enjoyed going on air. For all of the talent crew members and producers here at Bronco News Now, thanks for a great year. See you next fall.